San Diego, when Brian Houston wed his Mexican fiancée in a surprise ceremony during a rare opening of the steel gate on the US-Mexico border fence last month, he said it was because he could not cross into Tijuana. Now we know why. Houston, a US citizen, is awaiting sentencing in San Diego federal court on a drug smuggling conviction, a fact that the Border Patrol says it did not know when it ran a background check on him, clearing him to participate in the cross-border event at Border Field State Park. Houston was arrested in February as he crossed through the San Ysidro port of entry. Found hidden in his Volkswagen Jetta were 43 pounds of heroin, 47 pounds of methamphetamine and 43 pounds of cocaine, according to the complaint. The agents are upset, feel like they were taken advantage of, feel like they were duped, said Joshua Wilson, vice president and spokesman for the National Border Patrol Council Local 1613. Turns out we provided armed security for a cartel wedding. The incident could put future, door of hope, events in jeopardy. The event is closely monitored and choreographed, with a handful of vetted families on the US side allowed to embrace and greet family members on the Mexican side in three-minute reunions under the watchful eye of Border Patrol agents. The encounters are held on a small strip of land owned by the Department of Homeland Security known as Friendship Park. The enormous border gate has opened with fanfare like this 6 times since 2013. The event is organized by the Border Angels non-profit group, run by Executive Director Enric Morens. He gives questionnaires to interested families who cannot cross the border legally for whatever reason, and the forms are then provided to the Border Patrol for approval. Border Angels has never done any background checks, as the Border Patrol advised us they will do all background checks and advise us which families have been cleared, Morens said in a statement Wednesday. 12 families were approved for the November 18 opening, including Houston, although one family did not show, Morens said. Border Patrol spokesperson Tucky Michael said Houston was screened through an internal vetting process based on biographical information provided to us by Morens. A review of the provided information through our DHS systems did not indicate criminal activity, Michael said. The wedding between Houston and Evelia Rice was a surprise to agents. The couple, in only a few minutes, signed documents from the Tijuana municipal authorities, posed for pictures and hugged. The nuptials were widely covered by news outlets on both sides of the border, including the San Diego Union-Tribune. It's a statement that love has no borders, Houston told reporters at the time. Even though we are divided by a giant fence here, we can still love each other on both sides of the fence. He said his wife was working with an immigration attorney to get a green card to live in the United States. Wilson, the Border Patrol union rep, said Morens should have alerted the agents to the wedding. They showed up dressed for a wedding, Wilson said.